Welcome friends, this video is about the possible combinations in our birth charts regarding fame. See, this is one such topic which everybody is keen to know about, and we want to know if we are going to be famous in our lives or not. Friends, before proceeding further, I would like to tell you that I have started making videos in Hindi language also, as per the request of some of my friends on YouTube. So I would request you to watch my another video also on the same subject if you are knowing both the languages, because sometimes after making my first video, I just realize that I have forgotten to add one or two more points to it because I do not know editing. So I simply make the videos in one flow and it is very difficult to make the video again and again. So I just thought that in the other language, I would add those points. So please watch the entire video from beginning up till the end, and please do like, subscribe and share if you think that you have gained something through it, because my idea is to add some value to my videos so that it will help you in reading the charts of yours and your friends and family members. So it should be of use to all of you. So now let's come to the point. So the first combination that you should look out for is that the dasha in which you are born. So that is one of the most important things to look out for. So if you are born in a dasha which is of lagna or which is of your 10th house, in that case you will definitely get fame in life, or you will definitely have a good status in life. Sometimes you may not be born in the dasha of your lagna or your 10th house. In that case, if you are born in any other dasha of planet, that planet should be associated with your lagna or to your 10th house. Then also you will have fame in life. Now the second thing to look out for is the strength of your lagna or your ascendant, because ascendant is the most important aspect for a given native to achieve any kind of accomplishment in his life, to have the benefits of any Raj Yoga or any other good yoga. The lagna should be strong. If your lagna is weak, then you will not be able to enjoy the best of the yogas in your chart. So you should always wear the gemstone of your lagna first and foremost, irrespective of the fact wherever it is placed, because lagna lord, wherever it is placed, will never harm that house. So it will always benefit that house. Plus you will be benefiting your lagna also, because lagna is your body and your lagna lord is the life force energy inside that body. It is the soul, you can say. Lagna is also your head and lagna is also your entire self. So you have to make yourself strong in order to achieve something in life. So this is the second important thing that you have to see. And what is a strong lagna? The lagna which is unafflicted by malefics, the lagna lord which is well placed in kendra or trinal houses, and that lagna which is not aspected or posited by malefic planets is a strong lagna. Now these were two points. Now the third point is the 10th house of your Rashi chart. The 10th house, its lord should be present in the Kendra houses or in the Trinal houses. Then it will give strength to your 10th house, because 10th house is the status that you achieve by doing the kind of work that you do. It is not only about your career, it is also about your kind of work that you will do to achieve some kind of status. So even I have seen some people are very famous and they are not doing any work, but because of their good deeds they become famous. So it's not only about your career, it is overall status that you achieve by doing certain amount of work in the eyes of the society. So the 10th house should always be posited by Sun or Mars, because Mars will give you a high position and Sun will give you fame. If your Sun is in the 10th house, it is having highest directional strength and it will give you fame. In addition to it, I would say that there should be a dharam karam adhipati yog. What is that? When your 10th lord is making any connection with your 9th house or its lord, then it is called as the dharam karam adhipati yoga. 10th and 9th house are connecting to each other. But remember, this yoga should not be formed in the 6th, 8th or 12th houses, because these houses will spoil the yoga. This yoga should always be formed in the Kendra or in the trinal houses, and you will see that this is the highest kind of Raj Yoga or achievement in somebody's life. So this yoga should be present. The other thing is to see the placement of the 10th Lord in the D9 chart, in the Navamsha chart. Because see, if Lagna chart is the body, D9 is the soul of that body. So if your body is wanting to achieve something in life, if it is promising you something, but if your soul is dead, if it is not able to achieve those things in life, then how come are you going to get those things? What I mean to say is that if your D1 chart, Rashi chart, is looking excellent, it is looking very strong, but the same planets are looking weak in your D9 chart, then you will not get anything. So you have to watch the condition of your 10th Lord in your D9 chart. If your 10th Lord has gone to 6, 8 or 12 houses in your Navamsha chart, then my dear friends, it's a combination for struggle. So you will never be able to achieve high fame in life. The next thing that you have to look is the sign in which the 10th Lord is placed in your Navamsha chart. So if your 10th Lord is exalted in the Navamsha chart, or if it is in the Mool Trikon, or if it is in its own sign, or if it is in its friend sign, then it can give you good results related to your 10th house in the D1 chart. So this thing should also be looked at. Now, the other thing is that you have to also give some importance to the Arud Lagna. See, we always make a Lagan Arud, those who know Gemini. I will make a separate video on the Lagna Arud, but just by definition, let me tell you, if your Lagna Arud is placed in your Lagna or your 4th house or your 7th house or your 10th house, in that case, you will get fame related to that planet which is present in any of these houses. So you have to construct a Lagna Arud chart, and you have to see what is the Lagna which is formed in that Lagna Arud chart and what planets are placed in the Kendra houses. So you will have fame related to those planets. So this is a Gemini way to see things. Now, after this, we come to the D10 chart, that is your Dashmansha chart. So friends, now listen to me very, very carefully, because I am going to tell you some very important points which will help you to see directly some connection of fame from D1 chart to the D10 chart. The first thing is that you have to see the 11th house of your Dashmansha chart. If there is a planet present in the 11th house of your Dashmansha chart, then you will get fame related to that planet for sure. So whatever that planet is Karka of, you will get fame related to that. Suppose it is Jupiter, then you will get fame related to education or teaching. Suppose it is Mercury, then you will get fame related to business matters or commerce matters and many other things, because a Karka is signifying many, many things. So you have to be knowing the Karka meanings of all the planets, and then you can find out what is that Karka which is present in your 11th house of your Dashmansha chart, which will be giving you fame. Suppose it is Venus in your 11th house of your Dashmansha, then you will get fame related to Venusian things like music, fine arts, acting, cinematography, even computers also, because Venus gives you many, many things. So if you have Saturn present here, so Saturn is a significator of job, or it is also a significator of politics. So it means you can be successful in politics or at the place of work that you are doing. So friends, this is one of the ways to see the fame in a person's life. Now I'll tell you another method. Now come back to the Rashi chart. From here, see the 10th house from the moon. Wherever your moon is placed in the Rashi chart, count 10 places from that house, and the 10th house should either have some planet or some Rashi present here. So whatever sign is present in the 10th house, note down the sign lord of that planet. Now again go to the D10 chart. From there, see the 10th house from moon. Note the sign which is present in the 10th house to moon, or if there is a planet present in the 10th house to moon in the Dashmansha chart, then note down that planet's name. Now in the D1 chart, come back again and now see if these two planets, which were 10th to moon in the D1 and in the D10 chart, are these two planets connected in some way? If these two planets are connected to each other, in that case also you will get fame in your life. Friends, there is one more thing that you should know, that if you are having these combinations in your chart, then it doesn't mean that you will only get fame during their dasha periods. No, it means that you will generally be well placed in life and you will get fame easily. And during the dashas of these planets, you will have rise in life, you will have more recognition in life. So this is how you have to go about it. Before concluding, I would also like to tell you is that Sun is also a significator of fame. So if your Sun is present with any planet in your chart and it is ahead in degrees to that planet, then that planet related karka will give you fame. Suppose your Sun is with Venus, so you will get fame related to Venusian things. If it is with Jupiter, then you will get fame related to Jupiterian things. Likewise, you can see for other planets also. So friends, this was all about the combinations for fame. I will make another video in which I will tell you more about some Raj Yogas which also lead to fame. So friends, this was all about the combinations for fame, and I will come very soon with another video on another important topic, and I want to thank you all for listening.